exciting event. My name is Michael Fleiss, and I'm the head of powertrain in Gothenburg. And before that time, I was working with Bentley Motors in UK and also with VW in Germany. And I would like to tell you now a little bit about why I was joining the Volvo team, because there was a great work waiting for me to develop these new powertrains. Yeah, as you may have heard, we have a very radical strategy with our powertrains. We say four cylinder only, 2 liter maximum displacement, no engine above that. And this is not because we would like to do it. We have based that on very good research. We have systems in our cars where we can detect the driving behavior of our customers. And based on this data, we have decided to go to four cylinder only. And before that time, you may know that also, we have had a lot of powertrains, a lot of engines, self-made, bought from Ford, from PSA, and this was too much for our size. So we had, on the top here, you see the V8 engine, we have had the short S6, the 6-cylinder inline engine, the 5-cylinder and the 4-cylinders. And on the other side, you see the diesel engines, 5-cylinder and 4-cylinder, 2-liter and 1.6-liter. And we have combined these engines into one architecture each, one diesel and one gasoline architecture. And we have achieved commonality between the both architectures by 50%. So 50% of the parts are common between the both engines, which creates a good opportunity for us to have a very good manufacturing process. And obviously, we can increase the volume of the parts and by that get a better negotiation with our suppliers. And now you would say, okay, now Volvo makes a lot of profit. They take away our loft 8 cylinders and 6 cylinders, and they make a lot of profit. But it's actually not the case. What we have done, and there's a slogan at Volvo, we say, designed around you. And we really want to make sure that the car is designed around the customer. Based on my research, we said we go away from the big displacement engines because the customers are not needing them, and replace the drivability and the performance by the T8, the twin engine. And we have moved the amount of money we have saved more or less in the powertrain area into the cabin. We have this 8 great touch screen, we have the fantastic interior, we have the great design. So we have rebalanced the car, fitting better to our customers based on the research Lars was mentioning and my research. Yeah, so the advantages of this new powertrain family is a wide span of power and torque. So we go from 120 horsepower up to well above 400 horsepower. Very fuel efficient. We are currently, when it comes to performance versus CO2, world leading when it comes to CO2. Decreased weight, which is good for cost, obviously. Every kilo you save is multiplied by the material cost is saving cost, but also the balance of the car. You really would like to get rid of weight in the front to make sure that you have a good balance. And that is good for the chassis, for the ride, and so on. So you will really feel that this has helped. Efficient engine bay installation. With this common platform, we have got rid of the different of the installation of all of these different kind of engines in our cars. And we have reduced the size of the engine. It's transversal mounted. So we have low short overhangs, or short overhangs in the front, which gives the sexy proportions of the car. And we have a big cabin due to the small powertrain area. Yeah, now I'll talk a little bit about the gasoline technology. For the gasoline, we have a variable valve system, so both camshafts are variable. We have friction reduction, and that is based for good CO2. And this powertrain was based on a white clean sheet of paper, so we were able to create everything new, and we were putting a lot of attention into friction reduction. And that is a good foundation for low CO2. Advanced boosting, we have several twin charge systems on the engine. And advanced combustion, also very important, next to friction. good basic combustion to make sure that you have good CO2 and a lot of performance developed out of these power plants. And thermal management. On the gathering, for example, we have an electric water pump with which you can make sure that the water is heated up very fast and we get good CO2 also in the cold start. Yeah, the T6 all-wheel drive, the car you will have the pleasure to drive soon, is supercharged and turbocharged. And the supercharger has got a clutch, which is installed here. So we can declutch the supercharger. And the supercharger runs maximum up to 3,500 engine RPM. And then the supercharger does 23,000 RPM. And after that, the turbocharger takes over. So it's on demand, we switch on and switch off the supercharger. Yeah, this concept gives, as I said before, when we compare performance towards fuel economy, this concept gives really best in class figures here. And here, the dots you see there is our competition. And in the US, we are allowed to show our competition. Compared to Europe, we don't do that, but here we can do. So I do. and you really would like to be here. Here. High performance and high mileage. So the XC90 is here, BMW, Audi, and Mercedes. So we are outperforming our competition right now. Yeah, then talking about the T8, some of you have been able to drive that car yesterday, some will drive it today. Don't miss it, it's a fantastic ride. The SPA technology, Lars started to talk a little bit about it. We have for the T8, for the twin engine, we have a crank integrated starter generator which sits between the engine and the gearbox. We have an electric rear axle drive, that is an electric motor sitting here, powering the rear axle. We have obviously a battery which sits in the tunnel, so we have eliminated the prop shaft, and in that area we have placed the battery, which is very good for safety, very good for the balance of the car, the weight balance. By that, the shift by wire comes, and obviously electric air conditioning, so that the comfort is always maintained in the car. And as I said, the T6 is a V6 or inline 6 V8 replacer, and the T8 is really something on top of that. And now you would say, okay, these Volvo guys always tell us that they do so. But as an engineer, I have brought you some figures. And this is my engineers did this test. This is acceleration over time, and the red curve is a old XC90 V8, and you see the peak acceleration here, but then it is going down. Then we have the black curve, that's a car some of you have driven yesterday and some of you will drive today, the T8. Earlier, high acceleration and maintained longer. And to put it into perspective, we have put the Tesla 85 in here, which is a green curve. And even on that car, you will feel the difference. The T8 is driving faster. It's not a sports car, so it's a T8, but it's a pretty responsive car. Yeah, and with the T8, due to the battery in the tunnel and not like all of the others, or a lot of the others, on the rear axle, we have achieved to have a full seven-seating car. So it's world first that 7 persons can sit in a plug-in hybrid. And that's very important for big families wanting to have a sustainable drivability. Yeah, and all of the development was based on that we should make sure that you have a relaxed confidence in the car. So you don't get this big engine noise. You get a really nice ride in the car. You will experience that soon when you drive there. Yeah, some figures. For the T6, the gasoline, 320 horsepower, 295 pound-feet, and fuel consumption or mileage of 22 mpg. 0 to 62 miles, 6.1 seconds. And on the T8, 400 horsepower, 472 pound-feet. The fuel consumption will be or the mileage will be higher than 59 grams. We are currently in the certification phase, so we cannot give you exact figures. And you know, Swedish engineers are very conservative. They say 59 for sure, but it will be more. So watch the space there. But the acceleration, 5.6 seconds.